Please welcome Corporate Vice President, Azure Data, Arun Ulag.
Hey folks, absolutely delighted to be here. Welcome to Build. Thank you so much for joining our session. We've been working on something incredibly exciting for the last couple of years, and it's been very hard keeping it a secret, so I'm so excited that we've finally been able to, you know, bring it out to market. So I'm going to spend a few minutes just setting it up in terms of the problem we're trying to solve, and then I'm going to transition to Amir Netz, Justyna Lucznik, and Patrick Baumgartner, who are going to show you tons of demos so you can get a real feel for the product. We recognize that in today's world, it's literally awash with data, not just data from our transactional systems of record, but data from the world around us, the applications we build, the devices we use, interpersonal interactions, and so much more. And the challenge we're all struggling with is how do we translate this data into a competitive advantage? Because we recognize that in today's world, a competitive advantage starts with how we leverage data. Now, Microsoft has been at this for a while, so we have a comprehensive portfolio of analytics products that are widely used in the industry. And our products are used at massive scale today. Over 420,000 organizations around the planet used our products last month. We manage about 33 exabytes of data for analytics on behalf of our customers, and we process 8 trillion messages every single day. And we have over 5 million developers that build on our platform every single month. So if you look at the Gartner Magic Quadrants, and you pull the latest Gartner Magic Quadrants in 4 areas, you'll find that Microsoft is a leader in all 4 Gartner Magic Quadrants. So you have the Data Integration Tools Magic Quadrant, Cloud Database Management Systems, Cloud AI, and Analytics and Business Intelligence Platform. And the reason I bring it up is by working with Microsoft, you get really strong capabilities in each area. And in our opinion, you can lean on Microsoft to make all of these capabilities work seamlessly for you, so you as developers can focus on moving your business forward versus systems integration. However, the industry is at the crossroads today. And this in many ways started with the launch of ChatGPT just a few months ago, making AI front and center for every customer, for every developer. So AI is causing a massive platform shift today. But we know that AI is only as good as the data that it can work with. If you put garbage in, you're going to get garbage out. The good news is there's been a ton of innovation in the data and AI space. The bad news is there's been a ton of innovation in the data and AI space. So if I put myself in the shoes of our customers, there's massive fragmentation of the modern data stack. So I wanted to show you a slide put together by Firstmark Venture Capital. And this really shows you the complexity that's facing our customers today. Every little icon on the slide is a product or technology in the data and AI space, and somehow our customers are expected to make sense of it all to go from data to insights. Which is why, when I talk to chief data officers, the message I hear consistently is, please simplify, I want to be the chief data officer, not the chief integration officer. Which is why we are so excited to announce the launch of Microsoft Fabric today. You can think about Microsoft Fabric as giving everything you need as developers to go from raw data to insights in the hands of your business users, moving your business forward. We literally built Microsoft Fabric from the ground up to be ready for AI. Now, there's 4 promises we make as Microsoft Fabric. The first is a complete analytics platform that gives all of the tools that all developers need, whether you're a data scientist or a data engineer or a data warehousing professional or a BI professional, in order to be able to go from raw data to insights in the hands of your business users. And we're delivering all of these capabilities as software as a service, where every developer can simply sign up within a few seconds and get real value in minutes. The second promise is that we're embracing a lake-centric and open architecture. So we're introducing One Lake today. You can think about One Lake as a single unified SaaS data lake for the entire organization. We like to think about One Lake as almost like OneDrive, but for your data. We're embracing completely open formats. So Microsoft is moving away from proprietary formats, storage formats across our entire analytics stacks to completely open formats based upon Parquet and Delta Lake. The third promise is making sure that every piece of data in Fabric, every piece of data in OneLake is really moving your business forward through tools, through Power BI and Power BI's deep integration into Microsoft 365. So all of the data in Fabric automatically flows into Microsoft Teams, into Excel, into PowerPoint, into SharePoint, basically all the tools that your business users use where the data shows up for them versus they having to come to the data. And the final pillar is really the AI power, perhaps the most exciting part. Every part of the Fabric experience is infused with Azure Open AI Copilots, accelerating developer productivity, helping business users find insights in their data. So this is what Fabric looks like, right? So you have purpose-built tools for data integration, data engineering, data science, data warehousing, real-time analytics, Power BI, and a new product that Amir is going to talk to you about, Data Activator. Even though you have these purpose-built workloads, all of them look and feel and work like one integrated product with all of the data sitting in one lake. So to take you deeper into Fabric and show you some really exciting demos, I'm going to invite Amir Netz, Technical Fellow and CTO. Amir.
Thank you, Arun. That's me. Okay, ready to see some Fabric today? So we are going to spend the next 40 minutes or so. We're going to take a look at Fabric. We're going to really see a lot of demos, and we're going to use Arun's framework as the waypoint for our journey. So we're going to start with the first one. Arun talked about having a complete analytics platform. So what do we mean by a complete analytics platform? We mean that it's a single product. It's not a bundle, and it's not a thin UI shim on top of existing product, but it's a complete reimagination and re-architecture of a lot of virtually every analytics technology that we have. So when we talk about this single unified fabric, we talk about the integration of the experience, the single sign-on, the navigation. We're talking about how you create and manage project, how you do CI/CD, where you store the data, how you store the data. It's all one, just one for all. It's one compute that runs all your workloads. It is one way to do your governance and compliance. It's one way to find your data. It's one way to monitor your jobs. It's just one product. And as we go through the demos, you're going to see that we really mean it. It's not just a fake. The other thing that you're going to see is that it really is SaaS, software as a service. And if you come from the world of Azure, you're going to see a very, very big difference from the experience that you're used to. It's going to feel much more like Office. In fact, we're going to see the Office analogy again and again and again in this presentation. So when we talk about SaaS, we start with the 5x5 principle. 5 seconds to sign up, 5 minutes to wow. It means that you come in and you're instantly in, and you every time you want to provision a resource, it just shows up immediately. Just starting a new data warehouse is as fast as provisioning a new PowerPoint in the office. The UI looks much more like Office than anything else. And everything is auto-integrated. Everything is auto-optimized. There are minimal knobs. We take care of everything for you. And just like with Office, there's a concept of a tenant. Your entire organization is going to be in a single tenant. You cannot have two fabrics in the organization, just one fabric. And then just like with Office, the tenant is where you handle all the security, the governance, and compliance. You set it up centrally, and then every project, every developer, those policies are going to be enforced on them automatically. So that means that the enterprise can sleep sound, not worry about security holes and people things slipping through the cracks. But the developers also don't have to worry about those things. They don't have to be the experts in compliance and the experts on security. It's all managed centrally by the platform itself. And as we bring all these workloads together into a single product, we also mean that we're bringing many different types of people to work together. We're bringing the BI analysts, and we're bringing the data engineers, and we're bringing the data warehousing administrators, and we're bringing the data scientists. They're all coming and working together in the same workspaces, collaborating on projects, but each one of them is different. Each one of them has their own speciality. They want to see different experiences that match how they spend the day. So this is where we are bringing these persona-optimized experiences. And to show us a first glimpse of Fabric, I'm going to invite Justyna on stage. And Justyna is going to run our first demo.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you, Amir.
So what do we have?
All right, so we're going to start out by looking at some of these role-centric experiences that you talked about. We're actually going to go ahead and build our first end-to-end analytics project in Fabric. We're going to build our data warehouse project. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we're going to start out in the Power BI homepage experience. And Power BI is a perfect ecosystem for a BI user who wants to build things like their data sets, their reports. But Fabric offers many of these persona-centric experiences. So on the left-hand side and at the bottom over here, we can see things like data factory, data engineering. Let's take a look at the data science experience. And we can see all the recommendations update to things like notebooks, experiments. We can see we have ML models, getting started with those. But let's go ahead and actually jump into the data warehousing experience, and let's build our first data warehouse.
Let's go.
Okay, so this is going to be really easy. We just have to click that data warehouse button. All I'm going to do is give it a name. I'm going to select a sensitivity label, and now I can just hit create, and I'm immediately navigated to the warehouse experience.
So fast.
Yeah, I didn't have to spin up any storage accounts, no networking, no infrastructure. Okay, so now let's bring some data into this warehouse, and we have our pipeline seamlessly integrated inside. So again, now I'm navigated to the pipeline. I can select from a whole variety of different connectors. And we're going to go ahead and select Azure SQL as the source. We're going to go and choose the tables that we want to bring in. We're going to go and do all of our different column mappings. And that's basically it. My pipeline is now ready to go. I can go ahead and run it, and it's going to start replicating data into my warehouse. And there we go. We've got tables automatically created in our warehouse experience. I can get a preview of my table. I can filter things down. Let's say looking only at the Germany data. Let's go ahead and actually run a new SQL query to, you know, again, this is all integrated natively inside.
What about low-code?
Yeah, so we offer both ProDev and low-code experiences and across all of Fabric. In this case, I can just drag and drop my tables inside. I have this beautiful visual editor I can work inside. I can even do more complicated things like complex joins without having to write a single line of code. Now, over here, I've, again, seamlessly navigated to the built-in modeling view. And what we're actually doing over here is we're combining the data warehouse with Power BI in one single integrated experience, so it's really easy for these different personas to collaborate. And I can go ahead and build out my data model. I can create relationships between my different tables.
Measures?
I can write max DAX measures directly inside this experience, too. And we just take care of keeping all of this data synchronized, excellent out-of-the-box performance across the whole board. Okay, so now our data model is ready. Let's go ahead and create a new report. And again, this is all integrated inside. I can navigate to Power BI straight from here. I've got all my tables, so let's go and drag in some data. Let's see how much data we have here. We have 30 million rows.
That's good.
Good starting point. Let's build our report. And again, I can just build my Power BI report like I normally would. Now here we have our shared workspace experience, and we can see we've got our pipeline, we've got our data warehouse, we've got our report, all in one integrated experience. I can even navigate to this lineage view, I can see how all of these different things are composed together. And again, you saw in 3 minutes, I was able to go all the way from getting my pipelines, getting data into the data warehouse, building a Power BI report, without ever leaving the Fabric experience.
And it just flows. It flows, right? The pipelines, the data warehouse, BI, everything. And we'll see more. We're actually going to build way more. But to in order to be able to build more, we really have to understand the second pillar, because this is really where it gets to the heart of the product, to the architecture. And Fabric is lake-centric. It's open. And to understand that, you understand the central concept of one lake. And what is one lake? OneLake is like the one drive for data. I told you, you're going to have a lot of Office 365 analogies. So it just shows up, like just like you have the Fabric tenant, and OneLake is just there. You cannot buy OneLake. It's always there. You cannot have two of them. You know, two OneLakes doesn't work mathematically. So we're going to have just OneLake for the entire organization. All your users, all your projects, all your data are going to be stored in OneLake. And just like Excel, Word, PowerPoint store their data in OneDrive, all the workloads of Fabric automatically store their data in OneLake, organizing the data automatically by workspaces. And you don't have to worry about the organization. You never have to provision a storage account in your life. And then, once the data is in OneLake, you get a bunch of services on top of it. For example, it will scan your data for PII. It will index your data for search. It will figure out the lineage across the components. And if you mark, for example, a data warehouse to be highly confidential, then anything that reads data from the data warehouse becomes highly confidential automatically as well. It handles the sharing. Sharing in OneLake is just like sharing in OneDrive. Your compliance, governance, all of that is being done in OneDrive. So every piece of data is being every piece of data is being stored in OneLake. And it's not only that we store everything in OneLake, but it's the way that we store it is so important. See, we have this one thing that is called one copy principle. And with one copy, what we mean is that as you use the different workloads, for example, you use the Spark engine in order to create the lakehouse, or maybe use the T-SQL engine that you know from SQL Server and from Synapse to build your transactional relational data warehouse, or use the KQL engine to handle your telemetry and IoT outputs, and or you use Power BI analysis services to create your semantic models and your metrics and KPIs. Well, all of it is going into OneLake, but it's not only going to OneLake, it's all going to be stored in a single format. And we just abandoned proprietary formats. We are all going with an open format, which is Delta Parquet. Everything in OneLake is just stored in Delta Parquet, every piece of structured data. And what it really means, this is really important. What it really means is the moment you store something in OneLake, any of the compute engines stores something in OneLake, All the other compute engines can instantly work with it. You never have to load data from one lake into your data warehouse. You never have to refresh a Power BI data sets from the source, because all of them are instantly working with the same data. So there's no more data movement, copying, import, export. All these verbs are gone. You don't have to worry about them anymore. So in order for this to work, we have to add one more component, because we have now a lot of compute engines working on each other's data, because it all looks to them like it's the same data. But we have to make sure that the security is enforced uniformly. So you don't want to have one security model in the data warehouse, another one in the BI system, a third one in the lake. So we are introducing one security. And one security means that you are securing the data once, centrally, in the lake. Table-level security, column-level security, row-level security, defined once in the lake, and then enforced all over the place uniformly. So this is the heart. This is the beating heart of Fabric. It's one lake to store all your data. It's one copy shared across all your compute engines, and one security enforced uniformly everywhere. So to see how this is going to work, we're going to go and look at another sample here, another example, another demo. So I'm going to apologize to all my friends from Contoso. We're not going to use Contoso today, not Northwind and not Fabricam. We're going to actually look at a real database. It's the Microsoft Sales Database. We call it internally MS Sales. We have tens of thousands of users of MS Sales using the database every day. And you can imagine, in Microsoft, you heard about us. We have some sales. And so it's a lot of data. It's about 20 terabytes of data. It takes about 15 minutes to load it. What you see on the screen is the pipelines. You might have used the pipeline in Azure Data Factory, but now that part of Fabric, that's SaaSified, so they're just working like everything else, fully integrated with everything else. And we're going to use this one for our demo. So we're not going to wait the 15 minutes. It's already loaded, so we'll continue from there. And this is where you take over, Justyna.
Yeah, so what we're going to take a look at in this case is we're going to actually take a look, now that the data has all landed in the lakehouse, we're going to look at how all of these different data professionals can all collaborate on the single copy of data. So let's jump in. Okay, so I'm going to get started by being inside the lakehouse. You can see I've already loaded all of my data inside over here. I've seen my tables. And as a SQL analyst, I can just make use of the built-in SQL endpoint directly inside the lakehouse. So I didn't have to do anything to set this up. It just comes pre-wired with the lakehouse. And this navigates me to the immersive warehouse UI. And this is a completely revamped warehouse experience. Complete separation of compute and storage. The whole warehouse is working seamlessly on top of Delta Parquet files stored in the lake with excellent out-of-the-box performance. As we look at this UI, as a SQL analyst, it looks very familiar to me. I see my schemas, I see my queries, I see my tables. And I want to go ahead and actually, let's actually start by writing a SQL query. And I want to see how much data I'm actually dealing with in this MS Sales Lakehouse. So we're going to go ahead and count the rows of the revenue table. We're going to give it a second to run. And we can see we're dealing with 3.5 billion rows of data all stored inside the lake.
We have quite a lot of sales.
Quite a lot. Yeah. Okay, so let's go ahead and do something a little bit more complicated now. We're gonna look at our actual revenue, we're gonna break it down by fiscal quarter, we're gonna break it down by distribution channel. And if you actually look at this query, we're doing cross-database querying. So we're querying across our lake houses, our warehouses, we're gonna scan all 3.5 billion rows of data. Of course, this data is obfuscated data, not the real MS Sales data. But as I look at this data, I can see the results are back instantly. Looks like we're dealing with some data quality issue over here.
Yeah, the GUIDs here, right?
Yeah, it does look like some GUIDs have leaked in. So I want to, of course, fix this bug over here. And I'm actually going to use Spark to fix this problem. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to load up my notebook side by side. Again, the lakehouse is natively integrated inside my notebook experience. I can just drag and drop the table I want to work with. I've got my revenue table. I get a code snippet automatically generated. And you're going to see the session starts immediately. And things start to run immediately because we have pre-provisioned Spark Compute. We have live pools that are ready to go. So this, as soon as I go and hit things and start running things, we get results back immediately. OK, so let's actually write some Spark code to fix the bug over here. And what you're going to see me do now is as soon as this query finishes running, no magic, no intermissions, I'm going to go straight back into my warehouse. I'm going to rerun the query. And you can see the bug has automatically been
fixed. Because Spark is working directly on the same files the data warehouse is
exactly.
Working.
We keep everything in sync. OK, so let's keep going. So now that my data is all ready, we're going to jump back into that modeling view. Again, everything is just built into this warehouse experience. We've got our data modeling view built right in. And I'm going to now prepare my business model, get it ready for my reporting solution. OK, so now let's go ahead and jump back into Power BI. And we can see over here, we can see all of our tables, table names on the side. but no data has actually been loaded.
So no import.
No import, no. These are just pointers to the data that's still sitting in the data lake inside my lakehouse. And this is because Power BI now supports direct lake mode, which means Power BI can work natively on top of the Delta Parquet files all stored inside the lake. Okay, so now that we have our data inside, let's actually see again. Let's confirm how much data we're dealing with over here. You can see we're still working over 3.5 billion rows of data, again, all stored inside the data lake. And let's go ahead and, you know, just work on build a report. Let's have our actual revenue. Let's break it down by product name. Let's make this chart nice and big. Let's throw something else in. Let's go ahead and add, let's say, our fiscal quarter to the legend. And you can see this. I'm building out my report. I'm just getting
this fast.
It's amazing, interactive, smooth kind of experience. And again, this is, you're getting the performance of import mode, but no data has been loaded. Generally, working with this sort of data, managing these ETL jobs, it would have taken hours. You have no latency over
here. Direct click is a killer feature for
Power BI. It is. We're very excited about it. Thank you.
And what about Office?
Yeah, what about Office? So maybe let's take a look at Excel. Okay, so let's take a look. So we've got our pivot table again, working directly with our lakehouse, with our one lake data. And as I build out my pivot table over here, again, there's no data that's been loaded. We're still working with the data lake. And I'm going to now go ahead and slice and dice billions of rows of data in my pivot table over here, again, without moving any data movement whatsoever. Okay, so now we're back inside the lakehouse, and there you go. You saw how, you know, inside Microsoft Fabric, you can work end-to-end across all your different data personas, no data movement whatsoever.
So you can see the power of one copy, this one set of files in the lake, use it for data warehousing, use it for Spark, use it for Power BI, use it for Excel, no data movement, no data duplication, no need to define the security again and again and again. That is the principle of one copy. And we love one copy, so we want to take it to the next level. We solve the problem of sharing a single copy across all these types of computes. But people create copies for other reasons. For example, I could have two teams, and maybe Justyna is working on the finance data warehouse, and I'm working on the lakehouse for the marketing team, and I want the revenue table from Justyna. So often, what I will do is just create a pipeline, get the data exported from her warehouse, and put it in my lakehouse. But we can do something better, because everything is just Delta Parquet files in the lake, we can introduce something that is called shortcuts. And shortcuts are kind of like the shortcuts you use on your desktop, on your laptops, that are pointers to files and folders. So I can basically, if I have the rights, I can point to the files of the revenue table that Justyna have in her warehouse, and they instantly show up in my lakehouse. There is no latency, there is no data movement, they're always up to date, and there's not even a performance degradation. So we just share the same table without any performance degradation. And that's great. That's awesome when we have to share the data within one lake. But of course, we all know that one lake is kind of empty today. We just launched it, so all the data is somewhere else. The data exists in other storage systems. It can exist in Azure, in ADLS. It can exist in Amazon AWS, in their S3 system. It can exist in other clouds. And what we're going to do is we're going to allow you to create shortcuts to these other storage systems. And once you create a shortcut, again, there's no data movement. And it becomes, those files and folders become part of your one lake. So one lake is the one place that's going to have all the data for all the users, for all the regions, for all your clouds. One lake is a multi-cloud system. So to see how... So to see it in action, Justyna is going to come back and give us another demo.
Yeah, so now we're going to take a look at how these internal and external shortcuts look like. And we're also just going to see how easy it is to work with one lake. Okay, so let's jump in. And in this scenario, you know, I'm a data engineer. I've prepared all of my marketing data. I'm back inside the lakehouse. I already see my tables. And I want to actually reuse some sales data for lead generation reporting. Now, my sales team has been hard at work. They've already prepared a sales lakehouse. So I don't want to go and copy and duplicate data. I just want to reuse all the awesome work that they've already done. And so for this, I can use shortcuts. So in this particular case, you know, we want to actually create an internal shortcut to some data that's already in OneLake. So I'm going to select Microsoft OneLake as a source in this case. And I can see my integrated OneLake data hub. So I can see all my different warehouses, lakehouses. I'm going to select my sales lakehouse. I'm going to select the table that I want to bring in. And immediately, I can see the table appear as a first-class citizen in my lakehouse.
No data movement.
No data movement whatsoever has happened. Okay, but we know, of course, that our customers have existing investments in external data lakes that they also want to leverage with Microsoft Fabric. So in this particular case, we're again going to create a shortcut, but in this time, instead of doing an internal one lake shortcut, we're actually going to select one of these external sources. So of course, we can work with ADLS Gen 2, but you can even work with Amazon S3. Now, in this particular case, I want to go ahead and bring in some company logos, which I happen to have stored in my S3 bucket. So I'm going to select Amazon S3 as a source at this particular time. I'm going to specify the location of my data. I'm going to populate all my connection information. At this point, all I have to do is give my shortcut a name. I can specify the relative path if I want. And that's it. Immediately, again, we can see this shortcut appears inside the file section, which is more like the data lake portion of the lakehouse. And I can go ahead and actually just navigate through all of these different folders.
No data was copied.
No data was copied. And I can even open up the files directly inside this lakehouse, view them, despite the fact they're still sitting in my Amazon S3 bucket. Now, I have forgotten that I also have a line of finance logos. Thank you.
Thank you.
On my local machine. That I want to bring in. Now, the awesome thing is I can work with OneLink just like I can with OneDrive. So over here, you can see OneDrive. I actually have a OneLink folder that is synced as well. Okay, so I can actually navigate in my file explorer, yes, in my local file explorer, navigate through OneLink, go through my workspaces. I'm back in my marketing workspace. I can go into jump into the same folder that we're looking at, jump into the retail folder, and take a look at this. I'm going to open up that same image we were looking at in the lake house over
still,
here.
Still in S3.
Still in S3. This is still sitting in S3, despite the fact I'm working with it in my file explorer. Okay, so let's jump back into our lake house, and I'm going to jump into the files section. And let's go ahead and actually bring in this finance logos folder. And it is literally as easy as dragging and dropping this into my file explorer over here inside OneLake. It's just going to get automatically synced back into the lakehouse. So let's jump back into the lakehouse. Let's refresh the lakehouse, and let's take a look if it appears. Yep, it's right here, immediately available. And again, I can just navigate through it and work with this data seamlessly, traverse all the files, open up the logos inside here. So this is how easy it is.
So I just love the fact that by SaaSifying the data lake, we can make it as easy as OneDrive. Like, we show it to business users, they're falling in love with OneLake. Can you imagine? And you saw here how we really virtualize, you know, your entire set of storage, wherever it is. It could be in Amazon, it could be in ADLS in Azure, wherever it is, it's just all part of OneLake. Now, we're talking about business users, by the way. This is where we get, thank you, Justyna.
Yeah, thank you.
This is really we get to the other, the third promise of Fabric. Because Fabric is, you know, what's the point? What is the point of us collecting all the data, enriching the data, integrating the data, doing all these things if eventually the business users cannot make use of the data? And Fabric is perhaps the only data platform that thinks that business users are critical to getting your return on investment. So what we do is we take that Fabric, all the data, and we bring it to the users wherever they work. We don't ask the users to come to us. We bring the data to them. And to show us how all the data in Fabric gets to the user as they work in their favorite set of applications in Microsoft Office 365, I'm going to invite Patrick to join me on stage. And I was told not to turn around while he's on stage. Tell me if you're here.
All right, thanks. Thanks, okay. So what we know is there's amazing data inside of Fabric, but that data has to get used to create maximum impact. And so we've learned over time that the best way to get data used is to bring it to everywhere that users work. And so let's go ahead and take a look here, and we'll walk through how we do that. So this all starts in Microsoft Teams. So here I am in my Teams environment, and you can see right along the left-hand side, we've taken data and brought it up to the same level as Teams, as meetings, as files. Data is now just as important as all those other artifacts through the Power BI app in Teams. And just from there, I can find all of my documents that I like to use, all the reports, open one of those, and I'm slicing and dicing, finding insights instantaneously right inside of Teams without having to ever switch context to a different place. But it goes even further. I can take that same report and embed it into a Teams channel. So where my team works and collaborates and brings its files, my report's in the same place, and I can even do chat. So I'm going to actually ask Amir a quick question about this report. And Amir, what's going on with the ADATUM deal?
There you go.
I'm there very we go. Fast. Very fast typing. So we've got the answer there. Again, it's the same chat system. I didn't have to switch context. I didn't have to learn a different tool. We can even bring that report and put it into a meeting. So we can put data on the agenda of our meetings. I've got that report. It's attached to the meeting. So every time we go to that meeting, we find that data. But in this app, we also have the OneLake data hub inside of the same application. So I can find all of the best data available for me in my organization, what's certified, what's endorsed, what's promoted. So I can find the data that I want to do self-service and analytics with on my own. So if I open one of these data sets, I can see all of the related artifacts, the lineage, and I can get started with one click, either in Power BI or even in Excel. So just by clicking now, I have an Excel file that's going to get created, connected back to that same data, all the way through down into Fabric and into the lake. And now I can build a pivot table and drag and drop. It's that easy.
What about security?
And of course, the security flows all the way through. So I have the sensitivity labels in Excel so that all that data is remaining trusted and secure all the way from the business user back down to the lake. And it's an incredible capability. Even more, that same hub for all of my data shows up right inside of Excel as well. So I can go find all of the files recommended to me, all the data sets recommended to me. So just with one click, I can go ahead and open them. And so one last feature here. So now we're in PowerPoint, and this is one of the fastest growing features in Power BI, is the ability to take Power BI reports and embed them into PowerPoint. It's all live, interactive, works with animations, works with objects. It means a business user, you know, you're no longer copying and pasting charts, saving files. It's all just there, ready to go, and it's really cool capability inside of PowerPoint. We use that every day.
This feature we use all the time inside Microsoft completely changed the data culture because you get live data directly from OneLake into your PowerPoint. You can tell a story. You can answer other queries. It's just incredible. But sometimes we just cannot wait for the business user to understand what's going on with the data and to take action. Sometimes we just have to act in real time. And this is where Data Activator comes into play. Data Activator is a new capability introduced today for the first time, and it's an integral part of Fabric. And what Data Activator does, it's in real time. It's going to constantly observe all the data that we have in OneLake and then evaluate it to see if certain conditions are being met, if certain conditions that are triggering an action being met. And then if it finds it in real time, it will either contact the person on Teams or in Outlook, or perhaps it will activate an automated business process using Power Automate, or maybe call the stored procedure, or maybe call an Azure function, whatever you need to have done in order to really remediate the situation that you discovered in the data. It's all happening in real time on top of streaming data. So let's take a look at how Data Activator.
Yeah, so I'm really excited to show Data Activator is brand new inside of Fabric. Excited to show this demo. Let's go ahead and take a look. So we're going to be playing the role of a logistics company. We have tons of packages that we're tracking for delivery. So we have IoT sensors and data coming from an event stream looking at the temperature, the humidity, the truck status.
And yeah, it's changing and in real time.
Yeah, you can see the data updating in real time. And like I said, it's coming from an event stream, IoT sensors. It could also be coming from the lake. It could be coming from Power BI, all of these different sources. But what I want to do is go ahead and track the temperature. So I'm going to create a trigger on that. Each package, so let's pick each package here, and we're going to create a new trigger to track the temperature to see if the packages are getting too hot. And so now I can see a sample. We're seeing a preview of five of the data values.
That more than five packages.
Yeah, we're looking at thousands, but this could scale to hundreds of thousands, even millions of individual business objects, not impacting any of the performance of my other data. And this is a little spiky, so let's smooth it out. So I'm going to look at just an average of the temperature over every 5 minutes, just change that right in the UI, and now I'm seeing this nice smooth view. And let's go ahead and create a threshold for our trigger. So what I want to do is say every time this packet gets a little too hot, so say more than 32, I'm going to send each time that happens, fire this trigger. But I could also do it if it goes above that temperature and stays there for a certain amount of time, or if it goes above that amount a specific number of times over time.
What's the blue bar chart at the bottom?
Yeah, and the blue bar chart at the bottom is showing the number of times this would have fired for all of those packages that we're currently tracking. And again, that's a little bit more volume than I might want to have right now. So I'm going to go ahead and switch it as well to maybe a little bit higher temperature threshold. And now it's down just, okay, this looks pretty good for what our purposes are. Now again, this is all through the UI. Very easy to configure and get exactly how I want it to look. And now we can go ahead and do the associated action I want to do this. I could do an email. I could do a Teams message. I could do a Power Automate flow so I can tap into operational systems. I could also trigger other things inside of Fabric, like retraining a machine learning model or kicking off a pipeline. But for this demo, let's just look at creating a Teams message. So I've got my message auto-populated. It's going to be sent to Will here so we can take a look at it. And let's run a test action on one of these sample packages just so we can see what it looks like. So I'm going to switch over to Teams, and now we see that test message is generated. I can see the package ID, the temperature, very clean. This looks pretty good for what we want to do. And let's go ahead and go start this for all of the packages that we're tracking. Now, this is, you're thinking about in aggregate here, but what you really have to understand is this is working at the detailed level for each individual package. Like I said, it could be thousands of packages, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of packages.
How many we have here?
This is 5,000, but we're going to fast forward here in a second, and we're going to look, we have this set up for more data now for 173,000 individual business objects being tracked. We have some additional data and triggers that we've set up in our model. and get this beautiful view to see the heat maps of when these things are triggering, so I can really understand what's going on in my business, you know, either adjust the triggers I want or adjust my business processes to get my business where I want it and keep it there. Again, this is amazing capability, something we've always wanted to be able to do, and I'm not having to write a ton of code to do it. Super easy through the UI. We think this is really transformational for monitoring data and driving action on your data.
So real-time operational alerting just built into Fabric. Okay, we're done with three of those promises. And we are now having the last one. And this is, you know, we all talk about AI. The whole day was about AI. I'm not going to tell you how AI is changing the landscape and so forth. Let's just talk about what we're doing with AI in Fabric. And we're doing three things. We'll start with the first two. First of all, we're going to go and bring those copilots everywhere into Fabric. So if you're working on the data warehouse, the copilot will help you write better SQL statements and store procedures. For data scientists, it will help you do all the transformation and all the machine learning. If you're doing data integration, it will help you build the pipelines and the data flows and so forth. Just copilots everywhere. The other thing it will help you do is you have all this data now stored in one lake. We're going to allow you to create these chat experiences on top of it. We'll allow you to create these plugins that will go and work together with the copilot that you've seen in Teams, in the M365 copilot. So you can just build your own plugins that will work there on top of your own data. So to get a preview of what's coming into Fabric, I'm going to run this little sizzle video. So let's play it.
Next generation AI in Microsoft Fabric empowers you to unlock the full potential of your data. With Copilot integrated into every data experience, Microsoft Fabric lets you use natural language to bring your data to life. From integrating data to writing code to finding insights and creating reports, new transformative AI experiences work alongside you every step of the way so you can stay focused on getting value from your data. Copilot helps turn your words into data flows and data pipelines so you can intelligently integrate data from anywhere. When writing code, Copilot automatically suggests code and entire functions in real time, and Copilot can guide you to create machine learning models to unlock insights in your data. Just by chatting with Copilot, you can visually explore your data to create stunning reports, discover insights, and summarize your data into easy-to-understand text narratives for sharing. With Copilot, you can turn insight into action with triggers that monitor your data and notify users. You can even create your own custom natural language experiences that combine Azure OpenAI models and your organization's data and easily publish your creations as plugins. And with your data in Fabric, Copilot provides insights and answers everywhere work gets done. Most importantly, Microsoft Cloud runs on trust, which means your data always remains your data. Bring your data into the era of AI with Microsoft Fabric.
So the last thing that we do with AI is really help you get the insights. And this is where Copilot for Power BI is really playing a major role. And Pat, are you going to show us?
Yeah, Copilot? We are. And so, you know, this has been the most exciting time in my career, and looking at how to bring Copilot into all of these Fabric experiences. We're working really hard to bring it into Power BI. We're going to show a demo right now. Let's go ahead and run it of Copilot inside of Power BI. It's just transformational. So let's say I'm an analyst working for a hotel and resorts company, and you know I get asked to build reports all the time. It can take hours, even days, to build these reports. Now with Copilot, I can just describe in natural language the report I want to get created, and it's going to look at, in this case, let's look at the demographics of my customers that are returning, where they're coming from, what hotel property they visited, and just by describing that in natural language, it's going to go ahead and generate that report for me, taking away, you know, hours of work, dragging and dropping, and it looks beautiful, right? And so bringing that generative AI capability to build beautiful reports out of the box, still fully interactive so I can slice and dice, filter, maybe just look at the people who are visiting from booking from websites, incredibly easy to go ahead and create. And it goes even further. I can use Copilot to adjust the output automatically. So maybe I want to change the layout, switch which metrics are being used. And just with a couple clicks, I can regenerate the report, again, tapping into Copilot and the generative AI to go ahead and build the report. I can also ask follow-up questions. So maybe I want to ask, what are the key drivers for causing people to return to our hotel properties? So I just go ahead and ask that question, and Copilot's going to tap into the advanced analytics capabilities of Power BI and go ahead and add this key influencers visual to my report. So I can look and see that spa visitors are the Most frequent reason to return, almost twice as much. Amir, I know you love a good spa visit.
Who doesn't like a good spa?
Exactly. And so again, just asking a natural language, I've got an answer right from Copilot. I can also explore this visual even further if I wanted to look at the top segments in my data. Just by clicking, it's gone ahead and identified the key segments for if people are returning or new visitors, so I can explore my data even further. But let's go ahead and finish up my report. I'm gonna switch back to the first page and actually ask it to make it look like a different exec dashboard that we already use in my organization. So I went and found that report, relayed it out, changed the styling and the theme to match that other report. Again, saving me tons of work and making it look beautiful out of the box. It's still just a Power BI report though. So if I wanna click on one of these charts, change it to a line chart, let's add primary interest into the field so I can get a little bit more. That looks a little busy. So I'm gonna change it now to a ribbon chart so it looks a little more beautiful for my users. Again, I'm just using Power BI. Copilot's got me in the position to be able to do my analysis on my own. Now finally, one last capability I wanna show is I'm gonna ask it to change that last line chart to a narrative summary of the data. So Copilot's gonna look at all of the data in my report. It's gonna find some top insights and do a natural language summary complete with citations. So if I hover over those citations, it's gonna show me exactly where it found that insight. So now I have this beautiful report created just through natural language. We think this is incredibly transformational. We're bringing experiences like this all across Fabric. This is starting in private preview here at Build. We're incredibly excited for all of you to get your hands on it. And like I said, this is exciting times we live in. And so thank you very much.
What do you guys think? This is as close to magic as we can get with software. So this is Fabric, this is the journey, and I want to have Arun come back and take us home. Thank you, guys.
All right. Thank you so much, Amir. Thank you, Patrick. Thank you, Justyna. Isn't that absolutely amazing, folks? This is what we've been doing for the last couple of years. When I talk to customers about Fabric, I know the biggest question on your mind is what's available today. So that's what we're going to cover in this slide. So we're launching a broad public preview of Data Factory in Fabric, Synapse Data Engineering, Synapse Data Science, Synapse Data Warehousing, Synapse Real-Time Analytics, the Copilot for DAX authoring in Power BI, and OneLake itself. It's all available for public preview today. All of you can sign up within a few seconds. We're offering a 60-day free trial, no credit card required, no Azure subscription required. Power BI continues to be part of Fabric, so it still continues to be GA. We're also announcing the private preview of Data Activator, all of the Copilot experiences you saw in Fabric and Power BI are also available today in private preview. So next steps, okay, just two things for you folks, right? So please go up to Fabric, go up to sign up for Fabric, try it out, you know, play with it, tell us what you think. There's also a live event starting tomorrow. It's 2 half-days. So if you go into this link, aka.ms, build with analytics, then you'll be able to see, you know, get 2 half-days where we'll go deep into Fabric, show you all of the experiences, give you tons of demos and tons of information that you can immediately use in your new Fabric trial. So that's it, folks. This is what we've been doing. Thank you so much for joining us here at Build. We're really, really excited to bring this to you. Let's play the fire. Thank you.
We've been using these Microsoft platforms for several years now. Now, with Microsoft Fabric, being able to utilize all of those various services within a single user interface that's very intuitive, it's very clean, it's got the familiarity of Power BI in it as well, which is easy for us to adopt. So Microsoft Fabric provides some opportunities for us to improve our governance processes.
Microsoft Fabric elevates our process by reducing the time to delivery, by removing overhead, by using multiple desperate services. By consolidating the necessary data provisioning, transformation, modeling, analysis services into one UI, Microsoft Fabric meaningfully impacts Fergus's data storage, engineering, and analytics groups, since all of these workflows can now be done in the same UI for faster delivery of insights.
Priorities are heavily interrelated with data, and a lot of those organizations are really struggling with managing their data effectively. Fabric has the benefit of reducing data integration tax and unifying hybrid and multi-cloud data estates. And we're very excited to work with Microsoft on combining these capabilities with our KPMG One data platform to help our customers accelerate their data potential.
What excites us is bringing a single enterprise-grade foundation that will underpin customer use cases across AI, machine learning, and analytical domains. Microsoft Fabric will help Avanade elevate customer conversations to a more strategic level. We have a far expanded toolkit to address customer challenges.
Informatica is excited to be the design partner of Microsoft Fabric, working extremely closely with the Microsoft team. Informatica's intelligent data management clouds integrated with Microsoft Fabric experience will address critical customer challenges across enterprise data management, data quality, data integration, data governance, data catalog, and data privacy, real time, ELT, change data capture, replication, into the open and governed OneLake, into the Delta Parquet format is game changing.
We at PwC lead a lot of programs involving redefining business processes for our customers, supporting some very critical mergers and divestitures as well. And these programs run under a very tight timeline. With OneLake, the implementation becomes very simple by avoiding multiple data hops. We enable a data platform build much quicker and deliver insights to business much faster as well. The pervasive data governance is another key aspect that reduces the risk from the overall analytic platform build itself. Further, infusion of generative AI into Microsoft Fabric is going to be a game changer.